World's most insane fighter jet, F-35 aviation technology. Have you ever wondered what it's like to be in the cockpit of the world's most insane fighter jet? Picture yourself hurtling through the air at supersonic speeds, maneuvering through the most intense aerial battles, and dominating the skies with the latest aviation technology. It's not just a fantasy anymore. The F-35 fighter jet is a reality that has revolutionized modern warfare. Interested to know more? Well, you're in the right spot, so hold on tight. We're about to get on a flight. A large formation of aircraft from the United States Air Force, the Royal Air Force, and the Australian Air Force refueled in the dark before heading into battle. Fighters of the fourth generation from all three countries worked in tandem with an E-8 Joint Stars Command and Control plane. This included American F-16 Fighting Falcons, British F-15 Eagles, and European Eurofighter Typhoons. F-22 Raptors and F-35 Joint Strike Fighters, accompanied by stealthy escorts, scanned the battlefield. Alarms rang and cockpit monitors lit up, revealing that surface-to-air missiles and incoming fighters were painting the formation with several radar arrays. Russian Su-30-styled enemy fighters started closing in. According to Travolis Jaws Simmons, commander of the 57th Adversary Tactics Group, on the last week of a red flag exercise, "We throw everything we have at the Blue Force and replicate the toughest adversary possible." So, what's so special about the F-35 plane? Before we continue, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and stay connected to us. One of the world's most sophisticated air defense networks was compromised by the F-35 fighter jet, which then relayed the information to other missile-equipped fighters like the F-16. The stealthy F-35 can reach speeds of Mach 1.6 and carry an internal payload of 4 weapons. The F-35's computing capability, rather than its weapons, is what sets it apart. That's why many refer to the F-35 as a computer that happens to fly, or quarterback in the sky. According to Major Justin Lee, an Air Force F-35 flight instructor, there has never been an aircraft that provides as much situational awareness as the F-35. An awareness of one's surroundings is priceless in conflict. For almost its entire existence, people have argued over whether the F-35 is a revolutionary platform or a textbook example of the Pentagon's wasteful approach to buying weapons. Both, as it turns out. The F-35 we know today was designed to be a versatile fighter jet that can fulfill the needs of a variety of armed groups. Pentagon authorities hope that with this new Joint Strike Fighter, they could streamline supply chains, maintenance, and training. In addition, it would make use of the same stealth technology as the F-22. Since its first proposal in 1995, the Joint Strike Fighter program has rapidly progressed into two competitive prototypes, Lockheed Martin's X-35 and Boeing's X-32, to meet the extensive needs of the United States Navy, Air Force, Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, or DARPA, and soon the United Kingdom and Canada. With the high-speed interceptor F-14 Tomcat and the tank-killing close air support A-10 Thunderbolt II both needing to be replaced, the new fighter, the Joint Strike Fighter, has its job cut out for it. Theoretically, replacing all these planes with one would cost less money, but the extensive list of requirements caused an avalanche of costly difficulties. Many people had doubts about the X-35's viability for mass production, even while it was still in the running for the contract. Let's talk about the specifications for Lockheed Martin's F-35. But wait a minute. Before we get into that, hit the subscribe button right now. And now, coming back to our topic. The original blueprints were probably modified due to design updates made during the years. The F-35 may be the stealthiest fighter in use today since it was built from the ground up with low observability in mind. A single F-135 engine with an afterburner active can generate 40,000 pounds of force, propelling the elegant yet heavy fighter to speeds of up to Mach 1.6. When operating in contested airspace, only 4 weapons can be carried internally, but when flying in low-risk settings, the aircraft can be modified with an extra 6 weapons installed on external hardpoints. The F-35A also has a 4-barrel 25mm rotary gun installed internally, and it is concealed behind a tiny door to reduce radar returns. The F-35 can engage both airborne and ground-based targets with its conventional weapons payload of 2 AIM-120CD air-to-air missiles and 2 1,000-pound GBU-32 JDAM guided bombs. To eventually accommodate an additional 2 missiles, Lockheed Martin has built a new internal weapons carriage. Large touchscreens and a helmet-mounted display system provide the pilot with real-time data, replacing the plethora of gauges and screens featured in previous generations of fighter aircraft. The F-35 has a distributed aperture system, or DAS, and a set of 6 infrared cameras strategically placed around the aircraft, allowing the pilot to view right through the aircraft with the help of this helmet. Tom Burbidge, Lockheed's general manager for the program from 2000 until 2013, told the New York Times, "If you were to go back to the year 2000 and somebody said, I can build an airplane that is stealthy, has vertical takeoff and landing capabilities, and can go supersonic, most people in the industry would have said that's impossible. The technology to integrate these systems into a unified framework was not available to businesses at the time. Both the X-32 and X-35 prototypes performed admirably, but the F-35's challenging short takeoff and vertical landing flight may have been the determining factor. This new stealth fighter was designed to replace the AV-8B Harrier jump jets in service with the United States Marine Corps, hence, it needed to be capable of vertical landing and short takeoff. Boeing's X-32 prototypes were less advanced and had a more bizarre design than the rival X-35. Boeing considered this a selling point because using older systems required less upkeep. The plane utilized a Harrier-like direct lift thrust vectoring technology for vertical landings. To elevate the airframe, it essentially basically flipped the plane's engine upside down, making it less stable than the X-35 in tests. But maybe Boeing's biggest blunder was to introduce 2 different prototypes, one capable of supersonic flight and another of vertical landings. As a result of this decision, Pentagon officials became concerned that Boeing would be unable to fit all these systems into a single aircraft fuselage. The X-35's lift fan design involved a drive shaft running from the aircraft's rear engine to a massive fan mounted in the fuselage behind the pilot. The F-35, like the X-32, would point its engine downward when hovering, but unlike the X-32, it would also draw air from above the aircraft and force it down through the fan and out the bottom, resulting in 2 balanced sources of thrust that greatly improved the aircraft's stability. It also played a role in the F-35's aesthetic victory. A modern, high-performance, high-capable jet fighter, as depicted by the Lockheed Martin aircraft, looks like what I would expect a modern jet fighter to look like, says Lockheed Martin engineer Rick Rezebeck. When people see a Boeing plane, their initial reaction is typical. I don't get it. Although Boeing's X-32 prototype was more visually striking, Lockheed Martin ultimately prevailed in the race in October of 2001. The freshly christened F-35 had a promising future. As for F-35 variants, there's the F-35A, which is the conventional takeoff and landing variant and will be used by the United States Air Force and many of its allies. In addition to being the sole F-35 variant with a 25mm internal cannon, this plane is designed to take the place of a wide variety of other aircraft types, including the F-16 multi-role fighter and the A-10 Thunderbolt II flying cannon. The F-35B was developed specifically to meet the requirements of the United States Marine Corps in terms of short takeoff and vertical landing operations. Marines can use the F-35B's STOVL capability to launch the aircraft from the decks of amphibious assault ships, often known as lightning carriers, or from more remote runways. The F-35C is the first stealth fighter aircraft developed specifically for use by the United States Navy aboard aircraft carriers. It has larger wings than its competitors, allowing it to land on a carrier at a more leisurely speed. Carrier landings are easier thanks to the improved landing gear, and the extra fuel capacity of 20,000 pounds allows for more extensive missions. Folding wings make it possible to store the F-35C in the hull of ships, making it unique among F-35 models. According to Todd Harrison, an aerospace expert at the Center for Strategic and International Studies, the F-35 is an aircraft that is in many ways suboptimal for what each of the services wants. Hey, that's all for our video today. We'll be right back with more soon, so don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. And thanks for watching.